Fighting your own battle of the bulge and searching for a weight loss plan that actually works this time, well, that could be tricky.
Okay, it seems like diet trends change very quickly and the results don't always last. All right, some fad diets can cause some serious health problems if you're not careful with what and how much you consume.
13 Action News reporter Alicia Pattillo explores the most popular diets and why it's important to pay attention to those hidden dangers. Good morning, Alicia.
Good morning, ladies. Maybe you decided to ditch the carbs and you're done with junk food just like this, and you decided that you're just gonna live off of veggies. This is a big no-no. You're not getting enough protein, you're not doing enough for your body. So if that's you, you may wanna pay attention.
I love carbs, I love bread, okay, but it's not fun.
Meet Megan Keeney. She's been on a mission for the last 2 years to eat healthier, ditch the carbs, and lose the weight.
Yeah. I also do hard-boiled eggs for breakfast, or eggs in the morning as well.
This is what a typical morning looks like. She credits a certain trendy diet for her weight loss, a trend everyone seems to be talking about online.
High fat, protein, and very low carb. So the idea is to get your body in ketosis, which means that your body burns fat and not carbs.
Fad trends like keto or the gluten-free diet, organic, the Mediterranean diet, or low-fat diets seem to go in and out of style quickly, leaving people in the yo-yo effect, an unhealthy cycle of weight gain and loss.
There are some people that go really extreme with the keto diet and they're really skinny and they only eat like cheeses and certain things like that.
So the question is, can good diets turn bad? Health expert John Kinney says yes. If you're not careful with what or how much you eat, you could sabotage your efforts of losing weight.
You hear that all the time. People went on a diet, they lost 10 pounds. The minute they stopped, they gained 20.
John co-owns Greens and Proteins, a health and wellness restaurant here in the Valley. He says these trends are not designed to be long-term weight solutions, and oftentimes many people fall into the pitfalls of society's most popular diets.
Well, you'll see the symptoms of overeating real fast, because you're not going to lose any weight, and your pants will start getting tighter and so forth. But the real pitfall is not eating enough. Not eating enough protein is everybody's pitfall, because the mentality is, oh, I'm just going to have a little salad.
Here at Greens and Proteins, John sees his share of those following popular diet trends and the downfalls that come along with them.
A lot of people come in here and they're like, hey, I'm on keto or I'm on this. And we started this restaurant based on just that person. You can come in here, we have what's called your build your own menu. You pick a protein, you pick a green, you pick a grain, and you can pick a sauce. And so if you go to the menu and say, hey, I'm on keto, I'd like your build your own, what do you suggest?
Is this perfect for a keto diet?
Perfect.
If it sounds too good to be true, it probably is. So be cautious of popular diets and trends, as well as keeping track of what and how much you're putting into your body.
Okay, so remember, you have to eat enough. You have to pay attention to all of the ingredients. I'm gonna flip this back over. You have to pay attention to all of the ingredients on everything you eat, and you cannot just survive off of veggies and think that you are being healthy. Beth and Dana?
Now, Alicia, you've been doing the no carb thing.
I have. I've been doing no carb, no sugar. I am 12 days in. This just looks delicious to me right now, but I'm not gonna do it because I'm seeing results. So, you know, but I'm gonna make sure that I'm making sure that I'm getting my protein, mm-hmm. I'm getting all of my veggies, so I feel fit and I feel healthy right now.
Yeah, and eating Good. Enough. I love, love, love that. You don't have to starve yourself, mm-hmm. It doesn't work. Great advice, thank you. And good luck with your next. Yeah. I think she's doing it for 30 days.
She sat at her desk while we all ate pizza in the other room the other day, so I am proud of her.
Yeah, thank you.
It's a lot.